Hello there, and welcome to this first tutorial that I'm making. I'm going to make a series of those, and they are mostly focused on new players, and maybe some more experienced players can find something of value in there somewhere, something that they may have overlooked at some point. So let's take a look. Well, let's grab some help here, just the normal stuff. First of all, I want to look at hero combinations for rallies, for lairs, and other things that regard all of those things. And we can go to this place here, the Hall of War. This is the best place to set up the rallies. And we go down to this spot here that's called Troop Form Set. Open that, and then you can see a few formation sets. The higher your VIP rating is in the game, the more formation sets you can create. And I'm not sure how many you can create total, but I wouldn't be surprised if they are like 6 or 7 or something. I haven't figured that one out yet because I'm only at VIP 13. And that's basically only by just unlocking all the VIP tokens that I get in the game and occasionally spending a few diamonds that you get from quite a few events throughout the game. And as you can see, I set up here something that's called Zombie Raid, and as I am mainly set up as a shooter, so that will be my strongest shooter team. My fourth team here is my second shooter team, and in between are the fighters and riders, which are more or less obsolete for me, because riders I only use really when I go honeypotting. I will discuss that a bit later in a different tutorial. And the fighters, yeah, I use those mostly for short range honeypotting and killing bots and stuff like that, because I'm not too worried about the fighters getting killed. I'm usually only training those for a sacrificial lambs, more or less. So to take a look at the formation set, you have to click the cogwheel, and there is my setup. I have worked my way up to the T11s with a HQ of 35, and my shooter camp is at 35 as well, so I unlocked the T11s. And when you are trying to work on a strong shooter team, you have to make sure that your main heroes are set up to support the shooters as much as possible. So I have this guy here, Ephraim, who is a shooter. He gives you, so if we just bounce out all other heroes here, this one guy gives me a 250% boost on attack, defense, and hit points just by being there. He is he enhanced up to +8. And that is the highest that the 5-star heroes can get to. And I have actually enhanced this guy up to a 6-star, which is something that can happen after your hero hits level 310. This guy is already up to level 400, my only one that has reached that number. My next hero that I want to drop in there is this guy here, Griffin. As you can see, my attack and defense jumped 50% points. He is a 4-star. He is at plus 5, which is maximum for the 4-star heroes and everything below that. And he is maxed out at level 210. He can't go any higher than that. And Hartwell, she is also at plus 5, but I still have some ways to go to level her up to her max, because I'm not really aiming for that anymore, because I get everything I need for my raids, for the lairs. As she is giving me 50% boost on everything, on attack, defense and hit points. There is one more hero that I might start using soon. This one here. She gives me quite a fair bit of extra boosts, 64% on everything. But there is one extra skill, like a troop skill, that I will discuss a little bit later, which makes her not as strong as the ones that I replace her with. So instead I put in this guy here, Myers. He is a fighter class, but he gives a 40% boost on all stats, and he has this 500% tactical skill on top of that. And when Phoenix gets to plus 5, then she will definitely replace him. She is only at 300% tactical skill, but Myers is at 500. And then my last one, the shooter class, Requiem. She is at plus 8, and as you can see, she gives me 125% boost on everything for all troops. So I could be throwing in some fighters or riders there, and they would still get this nice boost. And I am working on building my so-called troop size. This is the maximum troops, the number of troops I can send into battle at one time without using some extra features like troop size bonuses and mega march and stuff like that. But this is how I set up. Let's back out again. Let's go into the fighter class. I'm pretty sure that this is not the strongest I can have. Let me take a look. I'll just throw this one out, and this one, and this one, and this one, because really I would love to have Myers in there. But unfortunately he is stuck doing other things. So let's drop down to the 4-stars. And this girl here, and this girl, Sanguine and Seo Yun, they give me 50% on all, except, well, both of them really need to get to level 131, which is why I haven't put them up there yet. This guy, he gives me 25% on everything. And this one as well, except for hit points. So I should have those in there. And this guy, he gives a fair bit of extra. He gives 26% on everything. Maybe this one is a good fit as well. Give some extra attack boost. I may want to replace some of them later. And yeah, let's leave it like this. And then the riders. I have set up for maximum efficiency there. I have one more hero that could step in there at some point. But since both Mars and Marlow, who are rider class, but they are full troop boosters, they are not strong enough for this. And this guy here, Obsidian, he is also not strong enough yet because of his lack of tactical skill. So that hopefully helps somebody. And then of course my second team, I have this Marlow character here, but I may want to replace him with this one here. And yeah, that's it. Thank you for checking this one, and happy gaming.